हेलो क्लास 11th स्टूडेंट, टुडे अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 5th थ्योरी ऑफ डिमांड फ्रॉम योर बुक इंट्रोडक्टरी माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. दिस इज पार्ट 3rd. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैड लर्न अबाउट व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय डिमांड. सो व्हाट इज डिमांड? डिमांड इज द क्वांटिटी दैट अ बायर इज रेडी टू परचेज एट अ गिवन प्राइस. ओके, एंड देन वी हैड लर्न अबाउट डिमांड फंक्शन. सो देर आर टू टाइप ऑफ फंक्शन वी हैड लर्न, मार्केट डिमांड एंड इंडिविजुअल डिमांड फंक्शन एंड मार्केट डिमांड फंक्शन. ओके, सो वट इज डिमांड फंक्शन? डिमांड फंक्शन एक्चुअली एक्सप्लेन द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द डिटर्मिनेट्स एंड डिमांड ऑफ अ कमोडिटी. इन वेरी सिंपल लैंग्वेज कि डिमांड ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर बायर, इफ यू talk about the individual demand curve, so demand of a consumer is going to affect from which type of factor. If your income will increase, so what will be impact of demand of a good? If price is going to be decreased, then what will be the effect on its demand? Okay, so that is known as a individual demand function. मार्केट डिमांड फंक्शन इट एक्सप्लेन कि डिमांड ऑफ ऑल द बायर हाउ इट इज़ गोइंग टू बी अफेक्टेड बाई वेरियस फैक्टर्स. ओके, सो इन टूडे वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इंडिविजुअल डिमांड फंक्शन एंड मार्केट डिमांड फंक्शन. ओके, ऑलरेडी आई हैड एक्सप्लेन यू प्राइस ऑफ एक्स. ओके, सो वॉट वी फाइंड, विच टाइप ऑफ रिलेशन वी फाइंड? प्राइस of a good and its own price. Okay, so if we going to write in mathematically equation, so we can write price of x is the function of demand of x, and we find between these two negative relation. Yani if price of, sorry, I had written it D here. Okay, so here will be demand of x and here will be price of x. Okay, so between these we find negative relation. If price of x is going to be high, it's mean demand of x good is going to be negative. If price of x is going to decrease, its mean demand of x commodity is going to be increased. So this is known as a negative relation. Okay, for example, you take the example of onion. If the price of onion is 200 kg, so you demand less. But if onion price is available only 20 rupees kg, 10 rupees kg, so you can purchase more. Okay, so this is the relation between price of a good and its own price. So which type of relation we find? We find negative relation. Okay, now after that we had learned about the related good. Okay, so price of related goods. Okay, so related good means there are two type of related good. First is substitute and second is complementary. Okay student, what is substitute good? Substitute good is that good that which is used in place of each other. Yani there are two goods X and Y, and these can be used in place of each other. Okay, so this type of good is known as a substitute good. Complementary goods, yani ki if there is two good, one is X and second is Y, and both are used together, Okay, what is the example of substitute good like tea and coffee? Okay, and what is the example of complementary good? The example of complementary good is fountain pen, या पेन एंड इंक पेन एंड इंक इंक पेन एंड इंक. ओके, सो दीज आर डिमांडेड टुगेदर. सो देर आर मोर एग्जाम्पल लाइक कोक एंड पेप्सी, बोथ आर सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ड्रिंक द कोल्ड ड्रिंक, सो इफ पेप्सी इज नॉट अवेलेबल यू कैन ड्रिंक कोको कोला. ओके, same way slice and fruity, so these are the substitute good. Scooty, bike, okay, pen, pencil, bell, ball pen, gel pen, okay, so these are the substitute good. Okay, complementary that is used together like petrol, vehicles, okay, pen, refill, ink pen, ink, butter, bread, bat, ball. So these are complementary good. If you want to play the cricket, you require both ball and bat. Okay, so this is what, this is a complementary good because both the good are used together. So let me understand which type of relation we find. So if you talk about related good, price of related good. Okay, so this is of two type. First is substitute good. Okay, so if you talk about the substitute good, here we are going to talk about related good. Here we are going to talk about other good. We are going to talk about demand of Y. We are going to talk about demand of Y. So here in price of related good, we are going to explain demand of Y good and price of X good. Okay, so we are going to explain the relation between these two. So which type of relation we find? We find positive relation. Okay, like it's mean what? It's mean ki if take two goods, X means coffee, okay student, and Y means tea. So suppose price of coffee will increase. It's mean demand of coffee will decrease. Demand of coffee will decrease. Okay, and there is no change in the price of tea, but still people started to drink or use more tea in place of coffee. So in this way, demand of tea is going to be increased. So here you find which type of relation? Here we find positive relation between what? Price of one good and demand of related good like coffee and tea. These are substitute good na. So agar price of coffee will increase, it's become more expensive, so people start to demand less coffee. Okay, and in place of coffee most of the people started to use tea. So in this way demand of tea is going to be increased. Okay, so this is what, this is a price of related good. Okay, similarly if suppose okay, price of coffee will decrease. Okay, so what will happen? Demand of coffee will increase now because it become less expensive. Okay student, and if you talk about the tea, the demand of tea will decrease. Why? Because coffee become less expensive, so the people who are not using still coffee, they started to use the coffee kyunki dono ke beech ka jo price ka difference hai wo kam ho gaya hai. So in this way whenever the price of coffee will decrease, okay, so in response its demand will increase and demand of tea will decrease. Why? Because people started to सब्स्टिट्यूट टी इन प्लेस ऑफ कॉफ़ी. यानी हम कॉफ़ी को ज़्यादा यूज़ करने लगते हैं, हम टी की जगह किसको यूज़ करने लगते हैं? कॉफ़ी यूज़ करने लगते हैं, कॉफ़ी पीने लगते हैं. ओके, दिस इज़ नोन एज अ रिलेशन बिटवीन सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड. नाउ वी टॉक अबाउट द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड. So second related good is what? Complementary good. Complementary goods. Okay, so what do you mean by complementary good? The goods which are used in place of each other, used together. The goods used together. The goods used together. Okay, student, these type of good are known as a complementary good. Like ink pen and its ink. Okay, so both are used together. Take the example of fountain pen. Okay, so if price of fountain pen is going to be increased, so in response demand of fountain pen is going to be decreased. Okay student, why? Because now fountain pen become more expensive, so demand of fountain pen is going to be decreased. And you will notice that the demand of fountain ink will also decrease. Why? Because these two, this pen and this ink, both are used together. तो जब आप फाउंटेन पेन को कम परचेस कर रहे हो तो ऑब्वियसली इंक की भी डिमांड कम हो जाएगी. क्यों? क्योंकि आप उस पेन में ही तो उस इंक को यूज़ कर सकते हो, उसका कोई अदर यूज़ नहीं है. ऑलरेडी फाउंटेन पेन 50-60 रुपीज़ मिलता है. सपोज़ करो उसकी प्राइस 100 रुपीज़ हो गई, तो अभी पहले से कम लोग फाउंटेन पेन यूज़ करेंगे. तो ऑब्वियसली जब फाउंटेन पेन लोग कम यूज़ करेंगे तो उसमें यूज़ होने वाली इंक की डिमांड भी क्या हो जाएगी? कम हो जाएगी. तो दिस रिलेशन वी फाइंड बिटवीन कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड. तो इसको अगर हम मैथमेटिकली एक्सप्रेस करें तो वी कैन राइट इट कि प्राइज ऑफ एक्स गुड एंड डिमांड ऑफ वाई गुड. ओके, यानी कि फाउंटेन पेन एंड फाउंटेन इंक, सो दीज आर रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर नेगेटिवली. आप देख सकते हो कि जब प्राइज ऑफ फाउंटेन पेन इंक्रीज करेगी तो डिमांड ऑफ फाउंटेन इंक डिक्रीज करेगा, क्योंकि फाउंटेन पेन की पहले से कम डिमांड हो रही तो ऑब्वियसली उसमें यूज होने वाली इंक की भी डिमांड क्या हो जाएगी? डिक्रीज करेगी. तो दिस रिलेशन वी फाइंड. ओके स्टूडेंट, आप सपोज करिए कि प्राइस ऑफ फाउंटेन पेन will decrease. Okay, so response में क्या होगा? Demand of fountain pen will increase. Obviously इनके बीच में negative relation होता है. जब भी कोई चीज़ less costly होती है हम उसे पहले से ज़्यादा consume करते हैं. Okay, in response demand of fountain ink will also increase. Okay, so here we find which type of relation? Price of one good and demand of other good. We find negative relation. When price of fountain will decrease, okay, so demand of fountain ink will increase. So opposite direction mein change ho raha hai, so this is known as a negative relation. Okay, so I think you are able to understand it. Okay, now here is given a difference between substitute good and complementary good. So already I had told you ki substitute means what? We can substitute, we can use one good in place of other good. Okay, like suppose karo ki teacher is teaching you and you are not having gel pen, so you can write with the ball pen. Okay, if pen is not you are having, you can write with the pencil. Okay, same way if you want to go to temple, if scooter is bike is not at home that time, only scooty, so you can ride your scooty also. So these are substitute good. If you are going outside, okay, and you want to drink cold drink, so Coke is not available, you can use any other cold drink. So these are substitute good, tea and coffee. Okay, so these are, what is the meaning of substitute good? Goods are those which can be interchanged for the use. Okay, here is given when price of substitute good increase, demand for given good when price of substitute good increase the demand for given good increase, यानी कि जब price of X increase करेगा तो demand of Y भी increase करेगा. कैसे? अगर coffee पहले से ज़्यादा expensive हो जाती है, okay, price of coffee increase कर रहा होता है, ठीक है, तो demand of coffee क्या होगा? Decrease करेगा. लेकिन demand of tea क्या होगा? वो increase कर जाएगा. तो यहाँ पे price of one good and price of other, यानी कि tea, इन दोनों के बीच में कैसा रिलेशन है? सेम रिलेशन है. ओके, सो लाइक टी एंड कॉफ़ी, दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड. नाउ टॉक अबाउट द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड. कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड्स आर दोज गुड्स विच कम्प्लीट द डिमांड फॉर ईच अदर. लाइक इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्ले द क्रिकेट यू रिक्वायर बोथ बैट एंड बॉल. ओके, सो वेन प्राइज ऑफ कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री गुड इंक्रीज डिमांड फॉर गिवन गुड, गिवन गुड मीन्स अदर गुड, फॉल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल फाउंटेन पेन, when price of fountain pen increase then demand of ink that is used in fountain pen is going to decrease. why? क्योंकि पहले से हम कम fountain pen purchase करेंगे, क्योंकि prices की क्या हो गई है? increase हो गई है. so that is written here. here is given example pen, ink, bread and butter and car and petrol. okay student, now next individual factor that is going to affect the demand of a particular buyer. So that the third determinant, yeah, the third factor is income of a consumer. Okay, so let me understand income of a consumer. If when you talk about the income of consumer, okay student, income of consumer, so we are going to explain it with normal good, okay, and inferior goods, inferior goods. okay student, normal goods means what? when your income is increased and in response demand, suppose there is X good, demand of X good is also increased. when we find positive relation between what? income of a consumer and demand of any good. so when we find positive relation then it is known as a normal good. like you take the example of Dove soap. okay, yeah, you can take any example. okay, इट्स मीन या क्या है इसका मतलब? ये होता है कि अगर आपकी इनकम बढ़ने पे भी आप जो गुड्स कंज्यूम कर रहे हो उसकी और पहले से ज़्यादा अमाउंट परचेस करते हो और उसकी डिमांड आप इंक्रीज़ कर देते हो तो उस गुड को हम क्या बोलते हैं? उस गुड को हम नॉर्मल गुड कर बोलते हैं. ठीक है, ओके. और अगर सपोज़ योर इनकम विल डिक्रीज एंड इन रिस्पॉन्स डिमांड ऑफ एक्स गुड विल डिक्रीज, ओके, सो दिस इज़ वॉट? दिस इज़ नॉर्मल गुड. क्या है? पॉजिटिव रिलेशन. सेम डायरेक्शन में चेंज हो, जिस डायरेक्शन में इनकम इंक्रीज करे उसी डायरेक्शन में आपकी उस पर्टिकुलर कमोडिटी की डिमांड भी चेंज हो. यानी कि इनकम डिक्रीज हो, डिमांड भी डिक्रीज हो, इनकम इंक्रीज हो और डिमांड भी उस पर्टिकुलर गुड की इंक्रीज हो. तो इस रिलेशन को, इस पॉजिटिव रिलेशन को बिटवीन द डिमांड ऑफ अ गुड एंड इनकम इज नोन एज अ नॉर्मल गुड. ओके, नाउ इफ सपोज इनकम विल इंक्रीज एंड there is any good that is X, demand of X is going to decrease. So this X good is what? This X good is known as an inferior good. Why? Because there we find negative relation. Income is increasing and demand of this X good is decreasing. For example, you can take the example of Lux soap. Okay? Ya fir you can take the example of डालडा एंड घी. वेन योर सैलरी इज लो तो यू यूजेस डालडा. ओके, बट वेन योर सैलरी इज इंक्रीजिंग तो देन यू आर गोइंग टू यूज घी इन प्लेस ऑफ डालडा. वाई? बिकॉज घी इज अ हाई प्राइस गुड तो यू कैन नॉट परचेज इट एट अ लो इनकम. ओके, सेम वे टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ साइकिल. सो जिनका इनकम लेवल कम होता है तो वो ट्रांसपोर्टेशन के लिए साइकिल का यूज़ करते हैं. ओके, लेकिन जिनकी इनकम हाई होती है वो क्या यूज़ करते हैं? बाइक यूज़ करते हैं, कार यूज़ करते हैं. समझ में आया? तो आपकी इनकम इंक्रीज़ होने पे अगर आप किसी कमोडिटी के कंजप्शन को इंक्रीज़ कर रहे हो तो वो नॉर्मल गुड है, लेकिन अगर आप उसकी कंजप्शन को डिक्रीज़ कर रहे हो तो वो आपके लिए क्या थी, इन्फीरियर गुड थी। आप उसका कंजप्शन क्यों कर रहे थे, क्योंकि आपके पास उतने पैसे नहीं थे कि आप परचेज कर पाते। जब आपकी इनकम इंक्रीज़ हुई तो आपने उसको रिप्लेस कर दिया एक बेटर गुड से। ओके, सो दिस इज़ द डिफरेंस बिटवीन नॉर्मल गुड एंड इन्फीरियर गुड। जब आपकी इनकम इंक्रीज़ हो और आप किसी कमोडिटी की डिमांड को डिक्रीज़ कर दो तो दैट इज़ कंसिडर एज अ इन्फीरियर गुड। ओके, और अगर आपकी इनकम अगर आपकी डिक्रीज़ हो और आप उस एक्स कमोडिटी की डिमांड को इंक्रीज़ कर दो तो दिस इज़ वॉट, दिस इज़ योर इन्फीरियर गुड। वी फाइंड हियर नेगेटिव रिलेशन बिटवीन डिमांड ऑफ एक्स गुड एंड इनकम। ओके, इनकम इज़ डिक्रीजिंग बट डिमांड ऑफ एक्स गुड इज़ इंक्रीजिंग। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ योर इनकम इज़ गोइंग टू बी लो, सो यू आर गोइंग टू परचेज मोर पोटैटो। ओके, इफ योर इनकम इज़ गोइंग टू इंक्रीज तो यू आर गोइंग टू रिप्लेस दिस पोटैटो विद द ग्रीन वेजिटेबल्स। सो दिस इज़ वॉट, इन दिस केस पोटैटो इज़ अ inferior good, you are using only potato, but when your income is increased you started to use green vegetables। okay, aisa nahi ki aap potato use nahi kar rahe ho, lekin aap potato ka pehle se consumption kam kar rahe ho। okay, one more thing ki there is not any good is inferior, not any good is superior, it depend upon level of income। जिस भी commodity का आप consumption decrease कर देते हो income increase होने पर वही commodity inferior बोली जाती है। जैसे for example आप लोग राजस्थान में जो poor section होता है वो अपनी staple diet, staple मतलब जैसे कि हम लोग राइस और चपाती लेते हैं और रेगुलर डाइट में, तो वहाँ पे क्या है, बाजरे की रोटी वो खाते हैं। क्यों, क्योंकि वहाँ पे बाजरा जो है स्टेपल वो कम प्राइस में अवेलेबल होता है, तो वो लोग मेन डाइट में जो पुअर सेक्शन है वो क्या लेता है, बाजरा लेता है, बाजरे की रोटी लेता है। ठीक है, तो क्या हुआ कि उस राजस्थान के पुअर सेक्शन के लिए वो बाजरा क्या है, वो इन्फीरियर गुड है। वाई, बिकॉज दे आर नॉट हैविंग सफिशियंट मनी टू परचेज व्हीट एंड राइस, सो दे आर यूजिंग बाजरा एज अ मेन डाइट। ओके, जब उनकी इनकम इंक्रीज कर दी जाती है तो वो बाजरा को रिप्लेस कर देते हैं अदर सुपीरियर फूड से, लाइक व्हीट से, राइस से। ओके, लेकिन अगर मान लो कोई हाई फाई पर्सन या जिसकी सैलरी अच्छी है और वो बाजरा यूज़ कर रहा है और वो इसलिए यूज़ कर रहा है क्योंकि वो डाइटिशियन ने बोला है या फिर दैट इज़ गुड फॉर द हेल्थ, तो वो नॉर्मल गुड है, क्योंकि जब उसकी इनकम और इंक्रीज़ होगी तो भी वो सेम अमाउंट इंक्रीज़ यूज़ कर रहा होगा बाजरा का। लेकिन जो राजस्थान के पुअर सेक्शन है उनके लिए बाजरा क्या, इन्फीरियर गुड है। क्यों, क्योंकि जैसे ही उनकी इनकम इंक्रीज होती है वो बाजरे का कंजप्शन कम कर देते हैं। तो रिमेंबर, जब इनकम इंक्रीज़ होने से किसी कमोडिटी के कंजप्शन को आप कम करते हो, ठीक है, इनकम इंक्रीज कंजप्शन डिक्रीज, तो दिस इज़ इन्फीरियर। इफ़ इनकम इंक्रीजेज यू आर यूजिंग सेम अमाउंट या मोर अमाउंट दैन इट इज़ नॉर्मल गुड। ओके, सो हियर इज़ गिवन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू understand this slide, change in income of the consumer also influence the demand for different good. The demand for normal good tend to increase with the increase, yani ki it is stated that ki if income increases demand of normal good also increases, yani we find positive relation. Okay, on the other hand demand for inferior good like coarse grain tend to decrease with the increase in the income, yani ki if your income is increased demand of inferior good is going to be decrease. Okay, here is given difference between normal good and inferior good. What is normal good? So normal good are those good in case of which there is a positive relation between what, between income and quantity demanded, yani ki demand of x is the function of income and we find positive relation in case of ye x is what, normal good. Okay, now here we find income effect is positive, income effect is positive, yani income mein increase hoga to demand of x good will also increase. Normal good may or may not be the essential of life. Okay, now next is, in case of normal good there is always inverse relationship between price of the commodity and quantity demanded. Okay, so yani ki if a commodity is a normal good and its price is going to be increased, yani price of normal good is going to be increased, yani ki demand of normal good is going to be decreased. So here law of demand is applicable. Okay, now let me talk about the inferior good. Inferior goods are those good in case of which there is negative relationship between income and quantity demanded. Yani ki demand of inferior good is the function of income and we find negative relation. Okay, yani ki income will increase. So in response, consumer demand for inferior good will decrease. Okay, so income effect is what? Negative. Yani ki if income will increase, demand will decrease. So negative relation, opposite direction mein both are changing. Now inferior goods are essential of life. Other words, people buy inferior goods largely because they are essential for life, like coarse grain, coarse cloth. Okay, now talk about the in case of inferior good, there may or may not be inverse relation between own price of the commodity and quantity demanded. Okay, so inferior good ke case mein law of demand applicable hai to wo inferior bola jata hai, aur agar nahi ho raha hai tab use giffen good bola jata hai. Okay, now next factor is taste and preference. Next topic is taste and preference. So let me understand it. So taste and preference can be favorable, taste and preference. So it can be favorable means that is in trend, that is in demand. Okay, like for example Android, for example, is Android phone. Okay, that is in demand, that is in trend. So its demand will increase. Jo bhi cheeze demand mein hoti hai, fashion mein hoti hai, like you can take the example of plazo pant. Okay, sarara, so these are in the trend, in the fashion, so its demand will decrease. If you talk about the salwar, if you talk about the leggings, so its demand will decrease. Same way, if you talk about the Android phone, so the condition, its demand is favorable. Yani people like to purchase Android set, so it's mean its demand will be high. Okay, if a commodity, its demand, it is unfavorable, the condition is unfavorable, that is not unfavorable. Okay, yani ki condition is not in favor. Okay, yani the commodity is not in trend, like keypad phone. So today keypad phone is mostly used as a secondary phone. Okay, otherwise it is used by the old age people. Okay, majority of the people are using Android set. So in this way, the demand of Android set is increasing. If you talk about the keypad, so its demand is decreasing. Why? Because it is not in trend, it is not in fashion. Yani its demand, its the condition for keypad is unfavorable. If you talk about the Android set, so the condition, the situation is favorable. Okay, so what is written here? The demand of a goods also depend upon individual taste and preference. Taste and preference of consumers are influenced by advertisement, change in fashion, climate, new invention, etc. Other things being equal, demand of those good increases for which consumer develop strong taste and preference. Yani ki jin commodities ke liye favorable conditions hote hain, unki demand increase karti hai, like Android set. Okay, now contrary to it, if taste and preference for a product is fading, yani decreasing, so its demand will decrease, like a keypad phone. Take a dressing sense, so you can take the example of plazo and leggings. The demand of leggings is decreasing day by day. If you talk about the plazo pant, so its demand is increasing. Okay, if you talk about the sport bike, so day by day the demand of a sport bike is increasing because it's the condition is in favor. New generation like to use sport bikes. If you talk about the simple, so other bikes, its demand is decreasing. Low cost price, yeah, that is not too modern. So that's demand is decreasing. Okay. Now, next topic is expectation. Okay. So expectation means what? If consumer find ki in near future there will be shortage of good. Okay, shortage of a good. So it's present demand will increase. Okay, for example, like take the example of sanitizers, mask 95. Okay, so these are what, when there is a starting of COVID-19 situation, the people started to purchase more and more sanitizer, that because there is a rumor that ki in near future there will be shortage of sanitizer mask, so people started to purchase at current price. In this way they started to demand it more. Okay, if people feel that ki in near future there will be more availability of more goods, so they will demand less, they will demand less at current price. Okay, why? Because in near future, if there will be more availability of the goods, it means price is going to be less. Okay, so people started to purchase less of it at the present situation. Like you can take the example of rice. If you are going to purchase rice this time, so you are going to find 32 rupee per kg or more than it. Okay, but at the time of harvesting, yani ki at the time of December, mid December and till March, yeah, for January, February, its price is going to be less. Why? Because it is the time of harvesting, there is the production of the rice. So people, if you talk about these months, so people purchase only that much rice that is required. They will wait for the December, yeah, time of harvesting. Why? Because rice is available in abundant amount. So because of that, there will be less price. So if people find that ki in near future there will be shortage of the good, it means price is going to be high. So people started to purchase it more at present. Okay, if people find ki in near future the accessibility of good is going to be more, so they started to demand it less at the present price. Okay, student. So what is written in your book? If the consumer expect a significant change in the availability of concerned commodity in near future, he may decide to change his present demand for the commodity. Particularly, if consumer fear acute shortage of the commodity in near future, he may raise his present demand for the commodity at existing price. Okay, student? Okay, so for today, thank you.